Hello, once again, good morning to all of you. As in my first video, I provided you the introduction of the poem along with the attitude of the poet along and the circumstances in which this poem was composed. Today, I am going to provide you more about the second stanza, third and fourth. In second stanza, the poet says, "Then took the other just as fair and having perhaps the better claim." Now you may understand in what way the poet says and what he did at last. He took the other because it was fair. Fair means good. And just after that, having perhaps the better claimed. He did so because it seemed better. It is very common choice. Everyone likes to do better, to have better, and with the same attitude, the poet does the same. The third line, because it was grassy and wanted wear, though as for that the passing there had worn them, really about the same. The tedious term wanted wear means took less, worn out, and passing means on walking. So you may consider, you may realize that the decision making by the poet was really based upon a certain logic. The logic was that the roads both were equally covered with leaves. No one had traveled, and so it was really a moment of confusion. Though, he says, though as for that the passing there had owned them really about the same. And the poet selects the road that appears at first glance to be less traveled. And by keeping ourselves in place of the poet, we realize that we can do the same what the poet did. My dear, in third stanza, he says, and both that morning equally lay. You may feel on that very moment, the roads were equally covered. It was very difficult to recognize. It was very difficult to decide which path would be better and which not. In leaves, no step had trodden black. In the second line, the poet says, there was no any sign or symbol left that could say that the path has been traveled by many people. And in third line, he says, oh, I kept the first for another day. This was the turning point of the poet's life. You may ask the question, why did he keep the first for another day? Very often, we people think that what we are doing today and would be remain shall be left for another day. In the same way, with word of regret, oh, it is what, my dear? A kind of regret. And before that, I would like to convey you this poem, The Road Not Taken. Actually, it is an acceptance of reality. The poet wanted to do something different from other people, so he chose the less traveled road. And when we go ahead, I mean the fourth line of the third stanza, it knowing how way leads on to way, I doubted if I should ever come back. I doubted why the poet had doubt, and the sentence is conditional, if I should ever come back. Do you think the path traveled can be revised? The decision taken earlier can be corrected? No, never. What we do comes as a result in our life. So it is very commonly said that well begun is half done. So certainly, before selecting the path, we must be very conscious and we should think over again and again. So he says, it knowing, jante hue, how way leads on to way, means it is the acceptance of the poet that what we select, that becomes the approaching path of future. Although he had some doubt, but he never removed it. He never overcame. And in the last fourth stanza, the poet says, I shall be telling with a sigh. My dear, you may realize why such idea has been brought here. Certainly, this line indicates the poet accepted his mistake, what he made earlier. I shall be telling this with a sigh.